Well, hello everyone, and thank you for having me. And please imagine being a scientist working on a breakthrough discovery. We all have dealt with running through abstracts, conclusions, references, just to get all the information we need. I mean, archive, Google Scholar, we've all been there, right? You all probably know the issue of searching for a meaningful article that can support your work and push your research even further. There are literally tens of articles, more or less correlated with your domain, yet you can never be sure to find something useful. Searching for these articles is also a very time-consuming activity. There are several services offering entire articles, while others offer only abstracts or conclusions, and it is on you to retrieve all the important information. And what if that was no longer the case? Imagine having all kinds of scientific resources in one place, aggregated from all across the web, and instead of browsing the internet infinitely, all these resources would be available to you in no time. In the European Open Science Cloud Future program, we aim at creating a recommender system that would significantly facilitate research in every domain. And at this moment, you probably wonder, why would I need a recommender system? And the answer is very simple. Recommendations are already all around us, and they are facilitating our lives. Imagine you are Homer Simpson. If you buy a beer, a recommendation system would also offer you a t-shirt that you would like and perhaps buy. Such a system is able to propose potentially useful and meaningful resources in the blink of an eye, while you can happily focus on your research. Obviously, you can't buy an out-of-the-box recommender system, and there are many challenges present in creation of this kind of stuff. The data is collected from open sources, which is web crawling techniques to obtain them, and as a result of crawling, both the quality and the reliability of the data is low, hence one of the tasks is to restore them so that they look as original as possible. You can see the very simple example on the slide, in which some white spaces separating the words are missing. There are several attempts to respond to this problem, one of which is using sophisticated linguistic algorithms that based on the linguistic knowledge about a particular language, and that allow us to restore the text to its original shape. But there are also problems that require much deeper insight and cannot be solved analytically. Namely, how to make computers comprehend concepts. When we, humans, look at some things, for example chairs, we can easily determine whether something is or is not a chair, even though each chair is different. Computers are not that good, hence they require us to teach them. In the recommendation system, it is crucial that a computer can compute how similar two objects are. And given, for example, two words, cat and kitten, a human can easily say that they describe the same term, while a computer would consider these two terms as different. When we talk about teaching computer, artificial intelligence is a term that follows directly. In our case, we utilize sophisticated natural language processing algorithms that are the very basis of making computers understand texts. Using neural networks, computers are able to learn how to differentiate whether something is a chair or not, or whether cat and kitten are somehow similar in their meaning. And it is the very game changer that lies at the heart of the recommender system. In the end, I ask you to be the change. Be the change that will make this world a better place and help young scientists improve their research. Make your publications available to everyone and allow people all over the world to use them to change the world around us. Thank you.